the growth of energy consumption coming from data centers will keep rising. Company building in the tech space, it's harder in Europe. Let's keep funding that, because prosperity ultimately comes from there.
Welcome to The Big Question, the series by Andrea Rocchetto, the CEO of Ephos. Andrea, thank you very much for joining us on the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you. Now, chip manufacturing, a hot topic at the moment, and where they're coming from, where they're going to. But can you explain what photonic chip manufacturing is? Because Ephos is a photonic chip manufacturing company, and not everybody watching is going to know what that is.
Well, photonics is the science and engineering of light, because our chips process information that is encoded in light. So our chips are special in one way in particular. We build chips with glass rather than silicon. So all the semiconductor industry builds chips in silicon. Most of our competitors in the photonic chip space build chips in silicon. And glass has a certain special property, which is the same material of which optical fibers are made of. And that's how we get internet in our homes and in our offices. And by using the same material as the optical fibers, we can minimize signal degradation that occurs when you stick together an optical fiber and a chip. It can be 100x more powerful in terms of data rates than a copper wire.
Okay, and what are these chips being used for at the moment?
So the range of applications of these chips is varied, from data centers, where they're used for networking, to building quantum computers, quantum sensors, quantum communication systems.
If a company wanted to use your chips, for example, what would be the benefits of using the glass chips over silicon?
In the context of data centers, is mostly a reduction in energy consumption. Quantifying that is a complex endeavor, because the overall energy footprint of a data center is extremely complex. There are lots of variables. We can use the example of Google. They are the only ones that really deployed this technology at scale in a data center.
Sorry, glass technology at scale?
Just the photonic technology.
Photonic technology, okay. Yeah.
And in the case of Google, we have a 40% reduction in energy consumption that resulted in a 30% reduction in financial cost of setting up the network infrastructure of the data center. With glass chips, you could do even better than that. But again, there are lots of variables at play, so let's stick with a conservative estimate of what the savings would be.
And using your glass chips, you say there that, you know, less energy will be used by using these glass chips that you're manufacturing. Can you explain how?
One of the reasons we waste energy when using photonics is because we lose information at the interface between the optical fiber that carries the information from A to B and the chip, which instead processes the information. By virtue of using the same material, we can keep the light happier so that it doesn't go away at this chip-to-fiber interface. We can be 20x more efficient. Our chips function at room temperature and in general help to reduce the overall energy footprint of a data center. So bear in mind that about 10% of the energy cost of a data center goes into networking, and about 40% goes into cooling. So there's a roughly 50% can be reduced by using photonic technologies like the one built by Ephos.
Now, the general consensus is that, of course, we know quantum computing is the next big revolution, but how is that going to affect data center energy needs going forward? How do your chips play into that?
I would say the trend for the growth of energy consumption coming from data centers will keep rising no matter what happens to quantum computers. It's certainly not a solution that will have any impact in the immediate term. And we all expect computing demands to increase significantly in the next decades. So whatever effect quantum computers are going to have, we're going to see the increase in energy consumption no matter what.
And chip wars, shortages, of course, too, a hot topic, with Europe relying very heavily on other parts of the world to import them, Taiwan, for example. So producing your glass-based ones in Europe, what could that do for Europe's independence and competitiveness on the world stage?
The production at the moment is completely done by us. We have built our pilot fabrication plant in Milan, Italy. And that's where we do our chips. We start from the raw materials that in our case are pieces of glass very similar to the glass of your iPhone, the Gorilla Glass. And from there, we build the chip all the way down to the control software used to control what the chip does. So chips are very much at the center of geostrategic competition. And certainly having an in-house manufacturing capacity is a great asset to have, especially in the case of tensions in the Indo-Pacific between China and the US. That capacity could prove particularly useful.
And have you found any obstacles with pushing forward your company, your product in Europe, regulations that have got in the way?
In general, I mean, company building in the tech space, it's harder in Europe, and we should not shy away of that. And I think there are three main reasons for that. One is culture, one is regulation, and the third one is talent. And they're all a bit intertwined together, but regulation is something that makes harder to transfer the technology from an academic lab into a startup. Regulation is what makes harder to fire people when there is a crisis in the semiconductor industry, which is a very cyclical industry. Talent. There are lots of bright engineers here in Europe, but few of them have built companies in the tech space that scaled. So you need that expertise to scale a company at some point.
And the way that you're using photonics to replace materials such as silicon in chip manufacturing, do you think this sort of creative thinking can be applied to find new materials for an important element in other industries in Europe?
I would call more than creative thinking, this is just hard science behind what we do. So ultimately, this is just a call for funding more basic science. We should never forget that from AI to quantum computing to fusion, it all comes from basic science. So let's keep funding that, because prosperity ultimately comes from there.
Brilliant. Well, Andrea, I won't keep you any longer, but thank you ever so much for sharing your insights and helping us to understand photonics in more detail and how it can help the industry become more energy efficient. So thank you very much. And thank you all for joining us on this episode of The Big Question. Don't forget, you can watch all our shows on the euronews.com website. Just head over to our business section. You can also check out all our shows on the Euronews YouTube channel. See you next time.